Hello, everybody. We're going to do a small Yoru guide just to go over all of his abilities, how you can use them correctly, and how you should be playing the agent. So first thing I'm going to go over is pistol round. So on your pistol round, you are going to buy... Decoy. This is what it should look like on pistol round for you. So you're going to buy a ghost and a flash, and you can also buy a fake out if you want, but I like to just go ghost and a flash, and sometimes I'll get a fake out, but occasionally not really. I like to save the $100 just for next round, maybe get a stinger or something, maybe a specter next round. So I just like to have the ghost. Let's go over his abilities. So the first ability he has is a footsteps move, and there are two uses for this ability. Two actives. There is the left and the right click. So the right click leaves down a little footsteps, kind of like a cipher cage. Then you can activate it by pressing F. Now what the footsteps do is they walk, obviously, and you can hear that they make noise. But one cool thing about them is that they can activate certain traps. Like, they can activate teleporter. They can blow up an enemy boombot. So I would like you to imagine that the footsteps are an actual player running. So if there is a cipher trip low enough to the ground, it'll trigger the cipher trip. It will also trigger killjoy turrets, alarm bots, and raise boom bots. So you can use it to easily bait out those abilities or trick people by blowing them up with your feet maneuver. Now his second ability is his flash. And the flash it's kind of difficult to use. It's a skill shot type ability where it has an arc, and then when you bounce it off of a wall, it will bounce off and flash like a Phoenix Flash, and I will show you right here. So the only way that they can see it is whenever it bounces. So if you throw it out, they won't see the little blue orb until it bounces and hits a wall. So you can throw the flash, and then once it hits a wall, that's when they'll see it. So if you were to do something like this, where you throw it like high up over here, they won't know until it bounces off, and then it's too late for them. So that is a very, very, very good way to use his flash. Another good way is doing like pop flashes for yourself, where if you are wanted to peek short, you can just throw a flash up like this, look down, and then walk out and peek people. But you can do something like that, where you peek out like that, and then just anything behind you or above you is really strong for this character, because if you look, you can see that the flashes go super far out, and you're going to flash your teammates quite a lot, but you kind of have to think of it as playing for yourself when you're using your flashes, so be careful when you're using them, as it's very easy to blind your teammates. His E ability is a little orb that you can place down, and it has a left and a right click, and the right click places it in place, and the left click makes it go forward until it hits a wall, and then it'll kind of go sideways on the wall if you angle it diagonally. So his E ability has about a 0.5 to 0.75 second time in between the the time you press E and the time you actually get to it. So when you're dueling somebody, if you press E, there's a good chance that they're actually able to finish you off before you can get back to your orb. So you need to be very careful when you're using your orb, as you are vulnerable while taking it. Now into his ultimate ability. His ultimate ability pulls out this little mask here, and you can see you gain a very high amount of movement speed, and you can see that you have this little circle around you. The enemies can only see you when they're in that circle. So as long as you are staying out of the range of the enemies in this circle, they won't be able to see you at all. So that is his ultimate and ability kit. One cool thing that you can do out of his ultimate ability is if you're holding E. So as soon as, and also you can end his ultimate early. Let me turn the sound up. So if you're holding E or spamming E as you get out of his ultimate, you can teleport immediately without taking any damage. And that is a pretty good combo if you're in the enemy team at the end of your ultimate and you don't really know what to do. Let's get into some cool things that you would be able to do with this character using his teleports, flashes, and ultimate. So one cool thing that I should note is that his teleport ability goes through the teleporter. And you can see just throws through like any normal ability, and you are actually able to teleport to it from anywhere. So you could do something cool at the start of the round where like you throw your teleporter here and it goes through the telly, then you threw a flash, and then as soon as it pops, you're out behind them and the flashes flash them, and you can get a bunch of kills pretty easily that way. Now, I'd like to use his teleport ability mostly as a way to take multiple duels at different angles. And what I mean by this is, for say, you are in U-Haul at first, so you throw your teleporter here, then you go over to short, and then as the enemies are running up short, you can start fighting them here, maybe throw a flash off the wall, then take your teleporter, and now they're thinking that you're over on that side, but now you're peeking from the left side. And it's an extremely strong way to get a lot of value from his teleporter. Now, another great way to use his teleporter is to throw it back towards your spawn at the start of the round, make a very aggressive play towards your side of the map, say like pushing out showers here, running up, getting the information, maybe seeing somebody. If you don't see anybody, then you can easily take your teleporter, and then you're almost halfway to B by now. So that is one of the strongest ways to get information with this character. Maybe even throwing your teleporter at the start of the round, then running up short, and then just teleporting back to B, and they think you're at A site. It's a really easy way to trick the enemies into thinking that you're stacking a site, but then you just go back to your normal site, and then you've stacked the second site. So it's a very easy way to be in multiple places at once. And his teleport lasts for a very long time when on the ground, probably like 20 to 15 seconds, actually. So it's a very, very strong way to get around the map and trick people very easily. Now, his flash goes extremely far. You can see that it almost goes like, let's see, that's 50 meters. It goes probably about 50 meters before it disappears. So you can help your teammates really, really easily with this. Say you have like somebody stuck in B long, you can just bounce a flash off the wall and then he'll be able to easily run out. So you don't have to use his flash to save your teammate, or sorry, to, you know, flash for yourself all the time. You can use it to save your teammates very easily. And that is probably one of his best tools, is his flash and his teleport. The rest of his kit is quite difficult to use. His C ability, the footsteps, is actually probably the most difficult to use. I would say its best use is either triggering boom bots, alarm bots, things like that. You can use it pretty easily, actually. There's a lot of Cypher players who use the ground trip here, so if you just throw it in both of these angles as you run into site, it might actually trigger both of the trips, which would be incredibly useful for entering site here. Now, another great way to use his teleport on attack is to use it to get behind the enemies. Now, the enemies can't see the teleport unless they're close, so if you do something like this where you throw it out onto the site, then you throw a flashback site and then a flash into CT, and then you teleport. You can teleport behind the enemies and they won't even know you're back here because the teleport has gone all the way past them. And another great use is just to just get it into these weird spots that people don't actually play. Then you can flash yourself in behind the enemies and get so many free kills. And this is one of the best ways to use his teleport on attack. I would say that if you're not going to use it to fake out an enemy, then you should be using it to get behind the enemies. And that is all I have for Yoru, guys. Thank you all for watching, and I will see you in the next videos where I go over specific map tutorials for him and teach you how to play every single map as Yoru. Ready? All now. He's right here on me. He's on logs right on top of me. Yeah. Raze is right here. On me. Pushing you guys. I'm body blocking her. I'm body blocking the rocket. Alt now. Phoenix right here on me. One more here.